Good morning, ladies and gentlemen. It's a pleasure to have you with us today. My name is Alpesh Patel. I am a partner at McKinsey & Company in Singapore, leading our work in Industry 4.0 in Asia Pacific and a network of digital capability centers. And it's a pleasure to not be alone on this panel, but to have together with me Francisco. Hi, Francisco.
Hi, Alpesh. Delighted to be here with you this morning and to be with all of you at the Industrial Transformation Forum. I'm Francisco and I'm managing what we call the Advanced Manufacturing and Value Chains Platform here at the World Economic Forum, joining from Geneva this morning.
That's great. So we're going to try and unpack a little bit the outlook for advanced manufacturing in Asia Pacific over the next 15 minutes. And the key question for this chat is, are we on course? Are we effectively on track when it comes to digital transformations? Francisco, the World Economic Forum has been leading a global initiative, the Global Lighthouse Initiative, to identify the best-in-class companies and those that have adopted Industry 4.0, the digital transformation at scale. What lessons are coming out of this initiative? And are those companies located in Asia Pacific? Maybe we should go to slide one and see what it tells us.
Absolutely, Alpesh. And maybe what I should mention first is that the Global Lighthouse Network is indeed a World Economic Forum initiative that we are running in collaboration with you and many of your colleagues at McKinsey & Company. And what is impressive is that, you know, when you ask the questions, are we on track across the world and are we on track in Asia Pacific? I mean, what we can see is that there is an increasing number of companies who are able to demonstrate the operational and financial impact that can be achieved through digital transformation. And if you, as you can see on the screen, you know, in total as of today, we have 90 lighthouses, all of which were identified through an independent selection and review process and that were recognized as leaders and front runners when it comes to digital transformation. And there's a group, there's a cohort within those 90 companies that is actually based in Southeast Asia. So I think that what that tells us is that there's still a lot of work to do, and these lighthouses remain a minority. We shared that in previous reports that we put together and that we published in the past. You know, 70% of companies worldwide are still stuck in what we call pilot purgatory, and that situation in which they are experimenting with technology, but not really able to deploy new use cases on the shop floor, and even less at scale across multiple facilities to be able to deliver impact. However, these lighthouses, the 90 points you see on the map, and those that you see in Southeast Asia, have been able to successfully navigate the digital transformation journey, and they are seeing the return on investment, they are seeing how it is paying off. And I think that all the dots that you see in the Southeast Asia regions are great examples of how the region is starting to step ahead, delivering impact, achieving new results through digital transformation. Let me be one comment, and then I'll hand it over back to you for you to comment as well, Spesh. But I had the chance to visit, for example, the Schneider Electric facility in Batam in Indonesia. What they have done there, it's really impressive, you know, how they have formed new teams, you know, joining OTIT people to drive digital transformation, to incubate new innovations. And we have seen some of the innovations that were incubated there not being taken, you know, by the company to global level. We have seen them starting to support some of their suppliers in the digital transformation journey. So I think that the potential is huge, a lot of work to be done, but we have great examples we can definitely learn from.
And it's true to your point that we start at least having now key examples in this region. If we think about APAC, most of the examples at the start were in North Asia. China, of course, has many, many, many lighthouses. Now we are seeing examples in Southeast Asia. Schneider is really a case in point. In Indonesia, it was, I think, the first lighthouse in Southeast Asia together with Petrosi, and they have managed to bring in their whole supply chain. So good to see that now. Singapore, of course, has also picked up with three lighthouses, Infineon, Micron, and HP. And we have seen in this current cycle also Malaysia and Thailand. So this is no longer a Singapore-centric event or an Indonesia-centric, or some exceptions in Indonesia, but all the countries are seeing a lighthouse. So irrespective of the overall macroeconomic factors, it is possible to become an Industry 4.0 lighthouse.
And maybe, Alpes, just one sort building on that is that through the Lighthouse Network, we are not looking for the factory of the future. Again, we are looking for companies who have demonstrated impact, who have exercised leaderships when it comes to delivering very tangible results to address operational or business issues through digital transformation. And these are companies who come from different geographies, who are at different levels of maturity. But what is unique about all of them is that they were able to leverage technology to develop tailored and solutions that are unique to their needs. And maybe if we move to the next slide, what we can show, you know, we are talking about impact. Well, this is what we mean by impact. So just for our colleagues to be able to follow us, what you see us that on the screen is the series of KPIs and metrics we have been looking at for each of the lighthouses. And each of the dots on the right side represents the given performance of a lighthouse, again, that given KPI. Now, when we said unprecedented impact levels, I mean, that's exactly what we mean. We are talking about greenhouse gas emissions being reduced down to 97% in some cases, waste reduction going to 80% in some cases, productivity, look at factory output increase being taken to 104%, productivity increases that in some cases go up to 200% and above. I mean, all that could not be possible without digital transformation and the investments that these companies have done in technology, but also on their people. I mean, something that is common about all the lighthouses in Southeast Asia is that they have all put in place significant and massive upskilling and retraining programs. And again, they are delivering benefits, you know, of course, on productivity, agility, speed to market customization, but also sustainability. They are taking impact beyond the traditional KPIs that we have been measuring and tracking over the past years.
Yeah, and when looking at this chart, I think one of the other elements that really comes to mind, right? This chart represents the impact of the 90 lighthouses. You see a very big scatter from zero to up to 250% of improvements on some of those metrics. So what does this say? It's really that the companies, the lighthouses, they haven't focused on all the metrics. They focused on the metrics that matter to them. I remember visiting Hire in China. They focused on quality cost reduction. They achieved a 96% reduction of the cost of quality, of the cost of basically goods that are not operating at the right level. So this is absolutely massive. But they didn't increase the throughput. Their key KPI, their key objective was the quality cost reduction. So it's very important. I think one key lesson, the impact can be big. It is created through technology. It is created, as Francisco, you mentioned, bringing the people dimension. But it starts by having the right focus. What is the right value driver? And what's the KPI I'm going to double down on and achieve that huge step change that you've noticed? And maybe if we go beyond the outcome, I think we look here at really what is the operational outcome or sustainability outcome of the implementation of Industry 4.0. If we now move to the next slide, we've also seen that The lighthouses not only focus on productivity metrics and productivity drivers like labor productivity, equipment productivity, as we were seeing on the previous page, but they're also focusing on other equations. One is growth and the other one is sustainability. I think it's quite amazing to see that nearly 100%, I mean 93% of the lighthouses have been able to enable growth either through output or even new revenue streams.
And I think, Alpens, maybe just to complement, I think that a big learning from all these lighthouses have delivered significant, let's say, impact on both growth and sustainability is that what we are realizing is that thanks to digital transformation, sustainability does not come at the expense of efficiency. These companies are starting to deliver value and impact on both productivity, efficiency, and sustainability at the same time, right? And that's an amazing and revealing fact and finding. Because if you look at the current context, right, the global landscape, and you look at how pressure is increasing from consumers, from regulators, you need to adapt the pressure that is coming from climate change itself, right? And we are seeing more and more disruptions being created from climate change. I could say that going forward, you need to have a sustainability future-proof organization if you want to stay competitive, if you want to to be resilient. So I think that that's the other big rebuilding factor that all lighthouses, or at least most of them, 64% is the number, enter the sustainability space thanks to digital transformation. Maybe one comment is that something that is common to all these lighthouses, if I was to summarize that at a high level, is first of all, in all those lighthouses, there is buy-in from the top. The CEO, the board is well aware and has made digital transformation a strategic priority for the company. The second one, and we have seen many examples coming from Southeast Asia, they have all adopted a bottom-up approach when it comes to innovation. They are sourcing innovations from multiple locations and have designed a structure that allows them to then scale them and replicate those use cases across the board within the same facility and entire value chain or across multiple facilities. Third is that they have massively invested in workforce transformation, upskilling and reskilling. The future of manufacturing is not about technology, it's about technology and people. The more we dig in, the more we learn about that. I mean, companies who were able to navigate the COVID-19 crisis in the most successful ways were those who were able to find a new balance in between automation and worker augmentation, right? And augmentation of worker through digital technologies. So I think the human factor is critical. And then maybe the final one is that all these companies are starting to look at digital transformation as the enabler and driver of sustainability. That is now the main priority and the right thing to do for every company willing to stay competitive going forward. But maybe, Alpesh, what we need to be talking about next is how can companies get started in the digital transformation journey? And another initiative that together with the Economic Development Board of Singapore, McKinsey, TUPSUD, Siemens, we have been scaling here at the forum is the Smart Industry Readiness Index, which we turn, you know, from being an amazing pilot project that was developed and launched in Singapore, has now, you know, is now becoming a real global initiative, you know, with a dedicated entity that is driving it and that will be responsible for deploying the CD assessment at scale. If we go to the next slide, maybe what do you, and you can comment on this, maybe Alpesh, but it's, you know, Siri, it's the main, or at least the reference benchmarking industry 4.0 tool that is now being deployed at scale. There were over 400 companies who went through the assessment. And what is most exciting is that we have been training an army of assessors that will be able to replicate the process across multiple geographies. But Alpesh, you should walk us through this chart.
Yeah, absolutely. So this initiative is quite unique because we have the example of the lighthouses, but what Siri will allow you to find out is where your company stands and what's the gap. So it's very comprehensive. We talked earlier about technology, about organization, the people, and about the processes, what KPI. So that's what Siri covers. Number two, it's very, very highly usable because it takes you 1 day, 1.5 day maximum per site, and you have a very comprehensive report that's independent, conducted by third-party individuals that have been assessed. And it's relevant to any company that is involved in the manufacturing sector, regardless of the size, the industry, the level of maturity, or the country. So it effectively gives that opportunity for you to figure out where you stand, how you get started. If we go to the next slide, it probably outlines a little bit better, a little bit more detail how you do this, right? The processes are vertical, i.e. what's happening on your shop floor, horizontal, what's happening in your supply chain or around the product life cycle. The technology, to Francisco's point earlier, covers automation, how much you are connected, the connectivity that has been implemented with IoT, as well as how much intelligence is being used. And then the organization side cannot be left behind, as I think, Francisco, you mentioned earlier.
Absolutely. I think that if you look at, you know, why Siri is probably the most amazing benchmarking tool that has been ever deployed at scale. First of all, is that because we have truly designed a process that allows us to run it, you know, across companies of different sizes, across geographies, across different industry sectors. You know, it is, the tool is sector agnostic, is company size agnostic. What we are building is the most amazing global database on industry 4.0 maturity that will allow us pretty soon to get a clear sense, and we will show some examples in a few minutes, but that will allow us to get a clear sense of where the world stands when it comes to being on track or not on the digital transformation front. And that's going to be generating insights that will inform not just how companies design their strategies and how do they take digital transformation to the next level, but think about also informing, you know, government policies, industrial strategy decisions for the way forward to be able that we can mobilize the support that is required for all companies to accelerate their process and progress and their journey. So maybe a quick invitation, you know, if you are following us this morning and you are running, you know, operations for any manufacturing companies, do reach out to us and we will be happy to put you in touch with the insight team that is running Siri so that you can go out and have a conversation on how to run the assessment. But maybe Alpesh, maybe one, you can show the our colleagues what is coming out of the light of the of the of those companies who run the Siri index so far.
Yeah, let's show on the next page what are some of the incoming insights from running this assessment across over 500 companies. And it's already very, very telling. The three lines here show on the top, the leaders, the top 10% companies. At the bottom 10%. And then the average is the black line. And basically, these companies have been assessed across the 16 dimensions we've shown earlier, with a band 5 representing a very high maturity and a band 1 basically the starting point. And you can see key differences here. The leaders in Industry 4.0 are already quite mature when it comes to shop floor connectivity. That's where the biggest difference lies when it comes to leaders versus laggards on the adoption. The second key element, enterprise connectivity, is also a key area of difference. So it really shows that connectivity, IoT connectivity, connectivity between the big data and the enterprise, is really what stands apart, what the leaders have started implementing, the lighthouses have implemented, that the laggards and the average need to catch up on. I think the second key area that's very interesting is on the organization side. The learning and development, so the upskilling, as well as the inter and intra-company collaboration, is significantly different between the leaders and the companies that are behind. And these elements really highlight the need for companies to tackle Industry 4.0, not as a technology exercise, but as a people exercise and as a sports game, not an individual company, but really with the entire ecosystem.
Excellent. And Alpesh, I think I really like how you position it, but you're not looking at where these three curves converge or diverge, you know, will help us inform a lot of decisions, you know, identify those areas in which support is needed for some companies, and especially the largest, to be able to catch up or even get started in some cases in their digital transformation journey. And the opportunity that we have is to really learn from, you know, the lighthouses, those who have excelled in this digital transformation journey as it's coming out of the Siri assessment. So I think we're at the end of our time together. So Alpesh, it's been a big pleasure once again to be on stage with you. And I look forward to staying engaged throughout the day at this amazing Industrial Transformation Forum. Thank you.
Likewise. Thank you very much.